I'm Dan, and this is Film Radar. Kingdom of Heaven is a film written by William Monahan and directed by Ridley Scott. William Monahan is most known for writing the adapted screenplay for Martin Scorsese's The Departed, for which he won an Oscar, and Ridley Scott is known for a slew of classics such as Alien, Blade Runner, and Gladiator. Scott is a filmmaker that is known for having many hits and misses, the hits such as the ones I've listed, and misses such as, well, you get the idea. Not that his misses are always particularly bad movies, just that they don't hold the same quality of some of his other work. Kingdom of Heaven is considered by most who have seen it to be one of his lesser films, but I am here to tell you that that is completely wrong. So what is Kingdom of Heaven? It's the story of a blacksmith named Balian, who at the onset of the film has lost his wife. A knight by the name of Godfrey comes seeking forgiveness from him and asks him to join his band of knights and travelers on their journey to Jerusalem.
Jerusalem is easy to find. You come to where the man speak Italian, and continue until he speaks something else.
What follows is a complex look at religious relations that are shockingly relevant almost 1,000 years later. A gorgeous cinematic work that depicts a conflict often spoken of but seldom seen. So what went wrong? Critics were in disfavor, it bombed at the box office. Even though Ridley was hot off the success of Gladiator and Orlando Bloom was really building some star power after Lord of the Rings and Pirates of the Caribbean, this movie couldn't seem to spark any interest in film critics or even casual moviegoers. Why? Well, there are many important aspects to making a movie, but one key component that often goes under-discussed is editing. Editing is where it can all go right or very horribly wrong. A film can have all of the workings of a masterpiece and get butchered in the editing room. And Kingdom of Heaven is the perfect example of when and how this happens. It had all of the right pieces in place, a brilliant dramatic score, a stellar ensemble cast, a proven director and budgeting writer with a massive budget to back it all up, and some bad editing decisions forced upon the director by the studio killed it. The director's cut runs 194 minutes long, an entire 50 minutes longer than a theatrical cut. You can't cut out that much material and leave behind anything but a carcass. The carcass of what was meant to be one of the greatest cinematic achievements of the last 20 years. The costuming, the art direction, the composition of every frame and the work of photography are all a treat for the eyes, but it's the depth of this story and the world that really transcends this film. It portrays Muslims not as violent heretics, but as an offended people seeking to reclaim their stolen homeland. It portrays Christians not as the justified defenders of peace, but as a melting pot of all different believers. Those doubting their faith, those seeking to do good in an unjust world, and those willfully manipulating the devout to ascend to power.
There must be war. God wills it!
God wills it! God wills it!
There's so much richness to this film on the topic of religion and religious relations throughout history.
There's your religion. One spark. A creosote bush. There's your Moses. I did not hear it speak.
It does not mean that there is no God.
Even though it may not be a perfect historic accuracy, it still captures what's important. That on both sides, there are just people. Some good, some bad, with a lot of innocent casualties on either side. So if you take my word on all that I'm saying, why would such an incredible film fly under everyone's radar? That brings us back to the major point of this video, the importance of editing. The final cut of the film was shown to the studio head at 20th Century Fox, who thought no one would go see a 3-hour-long drama about religious conflict, and had them cut it down almost an hour and market it as an action-adventure with a splash of romance instead. This isn't the first time that misleading marketing led to a box office disaster for Fox either, so you'd think they'd have learned their lesson. And you'd think with the success of movies like Gone with the Wind, Titanic, or Return of the King, that they would understand that a long runtime doesn't necessarily mean poor box office return. It all depends on your demographic and the quality of the film you have showing. Granted, those three are some of the highest grossing films of all time, so am I suggesting that Kingdom of Heaven could have made just as much money as those juggernauts? No, probably not anyways. But what I am saying is that people are more than willing to sit in a theater for over 3 hours and have proven that time and time again. To me, it comes down to trust. It's understandable why they mismarketed Fight Club. It's only Fincher's second film, and frankly, audiences took a while to go with the flow of that movie regardless of the marketing. But Ridley Scott had proved himself capable with plenty of movies over the years. He has made some of the most acclaimed movies of the last few decades, and a lot of his films have performed unexpectedly well at the box office. So why won't studios trust in him and let him release the movie he knows to be a hit? Why pry it from his hands and wither it to nothing? But it doesn't even stop there. The worst part of it all is that it, at least most likely, happened again with his most recent epic, Exodus. The original cut was 4 hours long. The theatrical cut, 2.5. they cut an hour and a half of footage from the movie. The animated movie based on the same story, The Prince of Egypt, runs an hour and a half, just to give you some perspective. They literally cut an entire film's worth of footage from the movie, and how did that go over? Critics hated it, and even though it made its budget back and then some at the box office, it was hardly the hit I'm sure they were hoping it to be. And go ahead, take a wild stab at which studio was behind it. Now, it may sound like I'm picking on Fox. I'm not. Every studio has made mistakes like this in the past, and this studio has released more than their fair share of great films. I just think that there is no better film to point to than Kingdom of Heaven for discussing what can go wrong with editing, and how studio meddling can backfire for everyone involved. Had the director's cut been released as the theatrical cut, it would have been showered with numerous awards and accolades, and with all of the critical raves circulating about it, it certainly would have performed better in theaters as well. So what's the lesson in all this? Firstly, go see this movie right now, and don't even think of watching the theatrical cut. Show some love to the editors out there, they have a difficult job, and when a movie is awful, ask yourself, really, who's the one to blame? Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.